Hello everyone, welcome to this short video on logistic regression hyperparameter optimization. In the logistic regression video, what we did is built a basic logistic regression with max iteration of 5000. We fit a model, and we also saw in that fitted model that there was so many hyperparameters that we could use to further optimize the logistic regression model. We got an accuracy of 0.95 or 96, and let's see if we can further improve this accuracy. For this example, we're going to use the breast cancer Wisconsin data set, and we're going to build another model, but it's just going to be with the hyperparameters optimized. So let's begin with the modeling process with hyperparameter tuning. If you want this particular code or kernel, it's present in the description section below. I have two versions. One is on Kaggle kernel and the other is on GitHub. You can download both of them or use any one of them to run this particular code. First, we'll begin by loading the libraries. Then we'll check where the data set is present. Once we get the location, I'm just going to load that data set in a data frame called as data. And then I'm going to divide my target variable and X variables into Y and X. So with Y, I'll only have the diagnosis whether that particular candidature has breast cancer or no, or is it malignant or benign. Now, the X variables will not contain ID, diagnosis, and unnamed 32 column. It'll basically have the rest of the columns. So let's check if the X variables have any missing values by doing x.isNull.sum. If I run it, you'll see that all of them is zero. So we're not going to have any missing values, fortunately. Let's look at some of the variables that we have. We have radius mean, texture mean, and so many other things that are there, and all of them are numerical, so we're just going to fit all of them in the model directly. We have roughly around 569 rows and 30 columns, so let's build the logistic regression with hyperparameters tuning. I'm just going to take a base version of the logistic regression here, right? Even I don't need this max iteration, I'm just going to create an instance of this particular model, right? And the parameters that we need to provide will be declared in this particular parameter grid, right? So you give the parameter name within single quotes and give a semicolon here, right? And then provide a list of the values that that particular hyperparameter can take. And then we're going to put them all into a dictionary. So we have penalty, which has L1, L2, elastic net, and none. If you want to read about what is L1 and L2 regularization, I have one article here where you can go through it. In this particular video, we're not going to go into the details, but rather focus on how we can optimize the model, right? Then you have C, which is again another parameter, which it should be a positive float, and the smaller value specifies stronger regularization, right? So it helps in that, and we're going to give some numbers to it. I'm going to give some amount of solvers. Again, I have another article which will help you go through what are the solvers and what are the advantages and disadvantages of all of them. I've just dumped all of them here, and I'm going to basically, you know, let the grid search give us which of them is going to be working best for us. And then I have taken max iteration to be 100,000, 2,500, and 500. We may not require all of this, but I'm just putting it in there in case, you know, it requires further iterations. So I've now packaged all the hyperparameters into this variable called as param grid, and I'm going to use this with gridsearchcv to let that gridsearchcv figure out which of these hyperparameters is going to be best and give us the best accuracy, right? So in case you want to read more of the details for this particular parameter grid, I have provided some links here. Please go through them. So let's import the grid search method now from sklearn. It belongs to the model selection package, where we are going to take the grid search CV. Now this grid search CV takes in multiple inputs. One of them is a log model that we declared here, right? So this is the one that it takes in as the first parameter. Then the parameter grid, whatever we declared here, it's going to take that one as a second parameter. Then we're going to give the cross validation to be as 3, and there are some other things that you can just give to basically run this a little bit faster. Verbose will basically give us all of these updates of what's happening when this grid search is looking for the best model. So once we have that, I have stored whatever this grid search CV that we have initiated into CLF. Now I'm going to take that CLF and then fit it with X variables and Y. Now, instead of having just run one model like we did in this logistic regression case, in this particular case, what the grid search CV is doing is it's running a combination of the parameters that we provide. So probably it will begin with L1, some value from C, LBFGS and 100, right? And it's going to take in all the combinations that are available within this parameter grid, and the amount of combinations that it's going to be coming to, it's around 4,800. So basically this grid search CV is doing 4,800 combinations, and it is going to identify the best fit for this particular parameter grid that we have. So it takes some time to run this parameter grid. I've already run it beforehand. It took me around 9.8 minutes to run this 4,800 fits. So let's look at what is going to happen and which is the best estimator, right? So I have this best CLF, which is holding these values of the fit. So I'm going to look at what are the best estimators that are provided there, right? So with the best CLF dot best estimator, I was able to get C is equal to 3792 as one value. Then you will see that max iteration was chosen as 1000, right? Penalty was L2, right? And the solver that we have is Newton CG. So if you go here, this grid search CV gave us L1 as the best parameter, then a value of let's say 3000 something here. Then it also took Newton CG as the best model, and 1000 iteration is sufficient to basically fit all this and get the best accuracy. Anyway, so once that is done, now we know that what are the best estimators, we'll see what is the accuracy that this particular grid search CV can give us. So if I run this particular accuracy test, it's going to give me 0.98, which is a significant lift from this 0.95, because we let the grid search CV run 4,800 combination, give us a combination that gives us the best accuracy. That's how we have used logistic regression to basically tune the hyperparameters that it contains. And this holds true for any other algorithm also, right? You have to basically identify what the hyperparameters are and then tune them to get the best model and use that to predict with more accuracy. That's all for this particular video, guys. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please do not forget to hit the thumbs up button and do not forget to subscribe to my channel.